We speak student!
3D geometry, a la Shmoop. Take a seat.
Revenge of the Triangles in 3D
is about to begin, pending a few previews. You saw it in Lamovision last week, but now it's going to be in all three dimensions, coming at you. Suddenly, there they are, those terrifying triangles. Only, they're not triangles anymore. They're prisms. Horrible, gory, flesh-eating prisms. Ever seen light refracted through those glass shapes to make a rainbow? 3D shapes have more than just length and width. They have depth, too.
Deep.
Most 3D shapes you can make by gluing a bunch of 2D shapes together. Be careful with crazy glue, though. You don't want to walk around with a cylinder glued to your head. A flat surface of a shape is called a face.
Are two faces not enough?
The line that connects two faces is called an edge.
This scene needs more edge.
And a point on a 3D shape is called a vertex. Prisms are two parallel polygons called bases with a bunch of lateral faces that connect them. They're named after the shape of their bases, so we could have triangular prisms or hexagonal prisms. Cylinders are like prisms, only the bases are circles instead.
Strike three!
Pyramids are like prisms, but with only one base.
Only one?
And cones are pyramids with circular bases. Spheres are like balls, but don't try playing basketball with that one.
Basketball's a fire!
They're not regulation. Those are the basic three-dimensional shapes, and the ones you'll probably see often. There are other ones like polyhedrons, but we won't blow your mind anymore for the time being. Now that you've got a grip on basic 3D geometry, you can sit back, relax, and enjoy
Revenge of the Triangles in 3D!
Or, well, try to.